Welcome to Edu Aero Classroom. In this tutorial, we will learn more about electricity. Now let us discuss on what factors the resistance of a given metal wire depends. For a given conductor, resistance is directly proportional to the length of the conductor. Resistance is inversely proportional to the area of cross-section of the conductor. Combining these two equations, the resistance is directly proportional to length of the conductor upon area of cross-section of the conductor. Removing the sign of proportionality and taking a constant, R is equal to rho L upon A. Rho is constant of proportionality known as resistivity. It is denoted by this symbol. SI unit of resistivity is ohmmeter. Rho can vary from very small values to very large values. The substances whose rho is very small are very good conductors of electricity and used in like metal wires, etc. The substances whose rho is moderate, they are known as resistors. And the substances whose rho is very large, they are known as insulators. They do not conduct electricity to much greater extent. The extent of electricity they conduct is very, very small. For example, rubber is an insulator. The resistors or the substances which have moderate resistivity are very applicable in our daily life. The heaters and electric iron we use in our home appliances are all based on the concept of resistivity. As they have a moderate resistivity, the current can flow quite easily. But this electric energy is converted into heat energy, and that is what we use at our home in the appliances. Let's now discuss about resistance of a system of resistors. Resistors can be connected in two ways, either in series or in parallel. Let us now discuss series combination of resistors. When the resistors are connected end to end in a circuit, the combination of resistors is known as series combination of resistors. In this figure, R1, R2 and R3 are connected in series. The current in each resistor in series combination remains the same, but the voltage in each resistor is different in case of series combination. Another important thing in series combination is that the total potential difference is equal to sum of potential difference in each resistor. That is, if V is the total potential difference and V1, V2 and V3 are the potential difference in the respective resistors, then V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Now by Ohm's law, we know that V1 is equal to IR1, V2 is equal to IR2, V3 is equal to IR3. And we know that replacing V by R, and we know that V equals to V1 plus V2 plus V3. V is equal to IR, V1 is IR1, V2 is IR2 and V3 is IR3. So we get IR is equal to IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3. Cancelling I on both sides, we get R equals to R1 plus R2 plus R3. So it means that we can replace these three resistors by series resistance of resistors R, and the resistance R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3, such that the same current flows and the same potential difference and same effect is produced. Now let's discuss resistance when the resistance of system of resistors when the combination is parallel combination. When two or more resistors are connected between two points, then the combination is known as parallel combination. In parallel combination, voltage remains the same. In the figure, the voltage in the resistors R1, R2 and R3 remains the same, but the current varies in each resistor. So the current flowing in each resistor, that is R1, R2 and R3, will be different. Another thing is, the total current in the circuit is equal to sum of current in each resistor. That is, I, that is total current, is equal to current in the first resistor, that is I1, plus current in second resistor, that is I2, and plus current in third resistor, that is I3. So I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3, and we know that The total current is total voltage upon total resistance, that is V upon Rp. So I, and by Ohm's law we also know that I1 is equal to V upon Rp, I is equal to V upon R2, and I is equal to V upon R3. So putting the values, we get V upon Rp is equal to V upon R1 plus V upon R2 plus V upon R3. Cancelling V on both sides, we get 1 upon Rp, that is the total resistance, is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3. It means that the three resistors can be replaced by a single resistors which can produce the same effect in this, which have resistance 1 upon Rp, and this resistance is equal to this expression. Now let us discuss the heating effect of electric current. When electric current flows through a conductor, resistance is offered to its movement, and this resistance produces heat in the conductor, and this is known as heating effect of electric current. Now let us calculate the amount of heat produced. We know that power is equal to work done upon time, and work done is equal to V from this formula. So, and we know that I is equal to Q upon T, so putting Q upon T as I, we get P is equal to VI. Now work done is equal to power into time, and power is equal to VI, so we get work done, that is heat energy produced, is equal to VIT. And we can write, so we get H equals to I square RT by replacing V with IR according to Ohm's law. This concept is used in electrical heating devices like heater, electric iron, etc. Now let us understand what is electric power. We know that rate of doing work is known as power, that is P is equal to W upon T, where W is work done and P is power, T is the time taken to do that work. We know that V is equal to W upon Q, so W is equal to VQ. Putting the value of W in this expression, we get P is equal to VQ upon T. P is equal to VI, taking Q upon T as I from this formula. So P is equal to I square R, putting V is equal to IR in this formula. And P can also be written as V square upon R, when we can write I is equal to V upon R. The effect of power is what? 1 watt is equal to 1 volt into 1 ampere, or 1 volt ampere. Now commercial unit of energy. The watt is a very small unit of energy. So commercially, we use a bigger unit of energy, that is kilowatt hour. 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 1000 watt, that is 1 kilowatt, into 1 hour, that is 3600 second. And this is equal to 3.6 into 10 to the power 6 watt second. And this is equals to 3.6 into 10 to the power 6 joule.